Thanks for watching. I'm meteorologist Jacqueline Thomas. Heading through the weekend, the quiet conditions are coming to an end now as we track this incoming storm. Alert weather on the way as we head through tonight and through the day on Monday. So what can we expect? Well, we're going to see snow, some of it heavy. This will all lead to difficult travel. Also a rain or some mix and a change over to snow as you head closer to the coast. Also this time around, some gusty winds, power outages a concern, so a lot that we're keeping our eyes on as this storm approaches. Storm impacts high for both heavy snow and difficult travel, medium for winds and outages, and then even coastal impacts are expected this time around. A lower impact, but nonetheless, coastal flood advisory in effect. Elsewhere across the state, we have a winter storm warning as you head from central and southern parts of New Hampshire, Nashua, Keene, all the way up through the Lakes region, Laconia included in that warning, over to Rochester. Then you have that winter weather advisory in those areas shaded in light purple from Plymouth up through Coos County and right at the immediate coast. Snowfall totals there will likely just be a little bit less. But either way, travel impacts are going to be high as the system moves through, increased impacts as the night goes on. So this storm arrives through this evening. Roads will become slick as the night continues on. Overnight travel impacts will likely be high. Difficult travel expected through Monday, and then you'll start to see those improvements as the system moves out and you can continue to get some roads cleared off and improved travel conditions later on Monday night. Otherwise, here's the timeline hour by hour as we head through this evening. This all moves in. We'll see snow starting to come down and that initial bit of mixing or even some rain possible as you head far southeast in the state. You'll notice temperatures there may be just a little bit milder, but elsewhere, especially north and west of Manchester or Concord, you're going to be seeing mainly snow, and that's going to continue as we head overnight into the day on Monday. Here's midnight. Notice snow across most of the state, but you head south and east of the Queen City, even south of Rochester, and you could be getting a little bit of a mix or even a little rain as you head into those early morning hours tomorrow. So as you head southeast towards the coast, you might wake up tomorrow morning and not really see much of anything on the ground, maybe a little slushy accumulation, and think, well, that's it. But it's not. And this is the tricky part here, is to keep in mind that for those areas that do see a little rain or mixing, you'll get into the snow as we head through the day on Monday, as opposed to overnight into the day tomorrow. The rest of the state likely sees all snow as we head through tonight and into Monday, but here's tomorrow morning, and notice that mixing in pink from Rochester down through Manchester, Nashua. You could end up with a little bit of a mix of some rain, some wet snowflakes, and perhaps a little bit of sleet as well. But that all begins to shift and slide away as we see that change over to all snow by the afternoon. Here's noontime. Notice right at the shore, you might still have a little mixing, but elsewhere you're seeing snow, and it could be heavy bands of snow that's set up. And this is going to give us some of those higher snowfall totals if we get in on some of those heavier snowfall rates. And notice that it continues as we head through Monday afternoon. So prolonged periods where snow is coming down. And this doesn't really wrap up until we head through the late day, early evening hours on Monday, tapering off and eventually coming to an end all across the state as we head towards Monday night. And it's going to taper off from north to south. So northern areas, as you head north of the mountains through Coos County, you're actually going to see some lesser amounts compared to some spots south across central parts of the state. So this is what those totals look like. You could end up with 1 to 3 inches far north, and as you head towards Berlin, you'll approach that 3-inch mark there. 3 to 6 inches as you head towards the Whites and down through Plymouth. There could be some isolated higher totals, especially across that higher terrain, but then a good 6 to 10 inches from Conway down through the Lakes region, through Concord, even down across the Monadnock region, Keene included in that, and there could be some isolated higher totals too. But it's that tricky part as you head south and east of Manchester, where you have to watch that mixing line setting up, and just how quickly we get that changeover to snow as we head through Monday, and how heavy we can see that snow coming down during the day tomorrow. But either way, 3 to 6 inches even possible across most of Rockingham County, and right at the coastline is where you could see some of those smaller totals of just a couple of inches. But either way, we all will be getting snow from this system at some point. It just, as you head south and east, might not be snow the entire time. So that's what we're looking at for totals. And also this time around, the winds going to be a little bit more of a factor. We will see a breeze as we head through Monday. Winds will increase in the morning, gusts around 20, 25 miles per hour, gusting to 30 during the day. And then winds will actually increase again on the backside of this Monday night. So after the snow comes to an end, we could see some gusts get boosted up around, or even potentially isolated gusts over 35 miles per hour. Rest of the week still stays active. Couple more chances for some rain snow mixing. We'll be keeping an eye on that. You'll want to stay tuned for those updates as we head through the next several days.